Happy Hanukkah, Merry Christmas, and Shalom. It's probably going to be the biggest failure of my whole life trying to tape a letter. But I figured it'd be something special for Christmas. Hanukkah. Maybe you'll even tape me one back, I don't know. It's kind of weird being away from home for Christmas. I'm sure you feel different. I don't know. A lot's been happening around here. Saturday evening. Hanukkah started on Thursday night. I really don't know the date. I'm kind of in isolation here. I don't know what, I don't know the date at all. I have no idea. It's around the end of November. And we started Hanukkah on Thursday night, had a big celebration Thursday night, and we at 7 o'clock, all the lights, we start dinner at 7, usually, only this night, we went up to one area, and all the people didn't get together, but some did, and they turned off all the lights in the kibbutz at 7, and we lit candles and walked to the dining room, and they turned the lights back on. It was just kind of opening ceremonies, and so we had a big meal, and I wasn't feeling too well. I didn't stay. They had a party afterwards. It was really, it's supposed to be good. And so then last night, Friday night, we always have, it's called Shalom Shabbat, because it's the evening before Saturday, which is Shabbat. And we always have a big meal. This night, we have a week long. Hanukkah is about a week, I think. And so last night we celebrated Hanukkah again and had a big party. I stayed for that. I was feeling good. Got kind of drunk. And it was fun. We had a nice dinner, like usual. And then after, a little later at 9:30, we had a big, they rearranged the place. And we had six different groups in the dining room. And they separated us into groups, and we had competition, and it was kind of fun, It was a little bit childish for a bunch of grown-ups, but there was kids and everything, it was all fun, It was just a lot of fun. We had all sorts of weird running games and eating contests. It's not the sort of thing I usually am into, but I had a good time. It was kind of fun in a way. So, I don't know, I can tell you a lot more about that, I guess. Let's see. So, you should be back from Hawaii now. I can't imagine that. Going to Hawaii and, which I want to know, really, about Hawaii. I'm sure you got some great pictures. Because I did take some pictures in Israel. I've got a roll here. I think it's 20. When is it 12? It's a 12. And I finished that and I'm on my second roll. And I think I've got a few pictures of a lot on that. I'll send that home with this and I don't know. If it airmail, it should get there, whatever, pretty fast, I hope. I can't hack the surface mail, I've heard, takes 2 months. I still haven't received my cassettes. Of course, I consider that it's regularly, I've heard, about 2 months for surface mail, but if you consider if I send something now surface mail, it'd probably take 4 because it's Christmas season. So, airmail, if I'm lucky, I might get a month or something, So I hope you get this by Christmas, because this is, I'd say, good three weeks from Christmas. I hope. I think 3. I'm not even sure what the... Oh, well. So I went to a lot. Let's see. I've been back from a lot now. So, about a week. I got back from a lot last Thursday. I was with a friend, a volunteer. We took off for about a week, and we spent about 4 days in Eilat and 3 days just kind of traveling. We did some hitching and bus riding, and spent 2 nights in Jerusalem with some friends. But the main thing was Eilat, you know, and it was, I just wanted to go down there because it's getting quite cold down there now. And it was very lucky that we went down there now, because it's only in another week or two, it's going to be so damn cold, you just can't sleep outside, you know. It's right there, and it's huge, the mountains around, you know, and just, it was a really desolate drive just from Tel Aviv to Eilat. It took about, 6 hour drive there from Tel Aviv across the desert, and it's just fantastic. I wish I would have got a picture of it. I didn't get a picture of that. So we ended up sleeping out and freezing. I wasn't too bad off. I wasn't cold, really. It was just a little inconvenient. We got pretty dirty. We were pretty dirty when we came back, and I hadn't shaved for a week. And so Eilat, we slept up on North Beach, which is very close to the town. You come into the town, and there's the Egged bus station, and you walk 2 minutes, and you're five minutes, and you're down at the North Beach. And then if you go from there, there's only like one road comes in and one road goes out, and then there's a town. And it's very simple, you know, you can't get lost, it's so small. So you take Yod Fatah Road, which is the name of the road south, which goes down along the Gulf of Aqaba there. It goes all the way down to the tip of Sinai, down to Sharm el-Sheikh. I don't know whether it's Sharm el-Sheikh on the map or Ophira, there's two names for it. And it's clear at the tip of the southern tip of Sinai there. And so you take that road down. We took a bus out to Coral Beach, which is, you know, is famous for its skin diving and the coral reefs. And they have, it's not much, it's a pretty bad beach. It's not nice sand or anything, but the whole thing is the skin diving. And I did take my stuff and used it in it. God, I'm thankful for that mask, you know. If I only was there once, it was worth it, you know. Because I'm sure I'll use that mask again, you know. But, it was worth it. They had, for people who didn't have diving masks, they had a tour boat out there, a glass bottom boat. And the glass bottom boat was running for, I don't know how much, but you could see through the bottom of the boat and see the whole thing, you know, if you didn't want to get wet. And the water was nice. It was very cool. It was not too, it wasn't real warm. It was a little bit cool. But I wish I could have got some pictures of the underwater, because there was nothing to compare with it, you know. It was, broken the law, I think. Illegal. They have these signs posted that says nature reserves the right or something. It says do not remove this and that from the beaches, you know, because it's all part of nature. That if you just stand aside, found a few pieces of coral that were broken off, you know, that were laying. So I picked them up and I got a couple seashells. I got this one huge shell that's laying outside the room right now because it stinks. I got some nice, the shells, but the coral was, the colors, there was white and orange and red, mostly, and it was the color of the ocean, just the color. It was blue, and the water was very clear. It wouldn't compare with the Caribbean, but the water was very clear, it was beautiful. We went like it's 5 kilometers to, 5 kilometers to, no, about, yeah, 5 kilometers out of Eilat is Coral Beach. And if you go farther, 12 to Coral Island, which is a small island I went to, I'll tell you about. And then 17 to the fjord, which I didn't go to. I heard that was fantastic. So, and the most amazing thing I found about the underwater was just the fish. Oh, there, and it's against the law, I don't know. It's against the law to, you know, to shoot spearfish or anything in the Gulf of Aqaba. So the fish are unharmed, and I don't think there's any, you won't see fish that are, you know, but.
As we leave this video, I hope you've had just a short introduction into some really interesting facts and areas about Israel. This was all during my living period there during 1972 to 73. In my next videos, I hope to show you some other interesting places I lived in Israel and